20 years ago, Isabel Manzanares lost her husband to chronic kidney disease. Then, one by one, four of her sons died from the same illness. In this sugar-producing region, the disease is so common and so deadly that a nearby community is now known as the Island of Widows.
I miss them. My husband and sons were the ones who helped me through my life. But now they're gone. It's sad when you lose loved ones.
Over the past decade, more than 20,000 Central American laborers have died from chronic kidney disease. While in developed countries, the illness affects older people with diabetes and high blood pressure, here in Nicaragua, it's young sugarcane workers who are hit the hardest. Toxic agrochemicals, heat stress, dehydration, and exposure to pathogens are some of the possible causes scientists are investigating. For those who've worked in sugarcane fields for decades and are looking for answers, one thing seems clear.
We are sure that the cause of the disease is related to working conditions at the San Antonio sugar mill. The men who work there are dying. And now the women who have started working there also have chronic kidney disease.
Salgado says protests have not been successful.
This is the entrance to Nicaragua's largest sugar processing facility. Earlier this year, hundreds of former workers gathered here to demand compensation for their illnesses. But after police opened fire, killing one ex-worker, the protests stopped.
Many say the intimidation continues. Juan says he was put on an industry-wide blacklist for leading a three-day sit-in protesting against working conditions.
They listened to us at the time, but after the sugar harvest, the company fired us. Now there are 150 of us without work, all because we tried to claim our rights.
While the San Antonio sugar mill didn't respond to our interview requests, they've denied the link between sugar work and chronic kidney disease, leaving thousands of widows still hoping for an answer. David Mercer, Al Jazeera, Chichigalpa, Nicaragua.